What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name's Damon Warren, and this is Day One Tech. And today, I've got a box unopening of the new DJI Avata 2. It's a FPV drone, first-person view drone. They did a couple upgrades to it. So I decided to get one, and this is going to be the box unopening. So if you're wondering what's inside the box, we'll show you in this video. And I'll go over my... So it was just announced yesterday, and I bought it through the DJI website. And I live in Wilmington, Delaware. And I got it next day. The shipping was included. Let's put that over there. Shipping was included. And one of the reasons why I ordered it through DJI, because I got the fly more, because I just feel better when I'm doing special FPV drones with the fly more. The fly more allows me to fly longer, but also the crash protection. Care refresh. All right. So I got it through DJI because I wanted to get the care refresh on it. And you also get points. So you can get money back straight from the website from DJI. And I could have got it from Best Buy. They had it. I could have drove there and picked it up yesterday. But I decided to get it through this. I also use PayPal to pay for it. And the reason why I use PayPal, because they have where they, it's like a no interest payments, so I can pay a certain amount every 2 weeks and there's no interest. So it allows me to free up some money, and it's been working great for me for getting different pieces of equipment. So if I don't have all the money right now, I can pay and then I have it now. So it's been working out really great. And they do the auto withdrawal from your bank account. So let's open this up. I went with the fly more because you get 3 batteries and a charger. And it comes with a nice case also. But the reason why, because with the other one, I got 1 battery and I would go through that battery super fast. And sometimes I just want to, like, you know, after work, I want to go flying and I don't want to have to worry about I got to charge, fly, because it takes about, you know, over an hour. All right, so there we go. The top says scan QR code for first flight. And here's the case. It should I say bag? It's a nice bag. I don't know what they call this stuff, but it's kind of like water resistant. Nice and padded shoulder strap here. Ooh, even this little handle right here, that's padded. Nice. It does not disconnect at the corners or anything, so this is sewn together. So that's on there. This little thing, there's a little outside pocket. It's a stretchy pocket too. It's got some elastic. So that's a little, it expands a little bit. That's good to know. All right. It's got two zippers. I feel okay. Opens up like that. Up at the top, you got, see what we got here. It's all your documentation here. We got our documentation. Quick start guide. Safety guidelines. Drone information notice. Flight safety rules. App safety card. Two-way charging hub. That they do have this available separately, but this is part of Fly More. I had the two-way charging hub with one of my other drones and I liked it. Went camping and I actually needed it. I used the batteries from the drone to charge my phone. And then we got some stickers. Take a look at what stickers we got this time. Got that one. That one. So those are the stickers that we got with it this time. What else we got in the top? Corrective lenses. So these are the corrective lenses right there. And you scan and set that up. This is the cushion for the headband thing. And this looks like a OTA cord here. Yeah. USB-C and USB-A. Couple of replacement props. I like how they package them this time. They're individually, they say A and B, so you know where they go for the matching. Some props, silica gel, make sure keep the moisture out. And this is USB C to C cord. This is a tool for putting on the props, taking off the props. And that was everything that was in the top part with the one little zipper right there. It looks like it's mesh, but it's just a, it's actually see-through, so you can see what's in there. This is the new controller. So this, this controller definitely feels smaller. It feels smaller, it doesn't feel as bulky. It fits very nice in the hand. Giggity. And they made a couple of additions. But yeah, it reminds me of the old RC cars. You could just, right there. And it feels like the throw might not be as far. So if you're not familiar with the way the Avata can fly, you can use this and you twist your wrist and move back and forth to fly. I actually like flying it this way. There's just a couple of different maneuvers that you weren't able to do with it. Now they have it where they have this side wheel to make adjustments, and then there's like a, you can flick it to the top and then it'll do a flip to the side, does a banking turn and then down. So there's a couple of different options. But I like the new improvement to the controller. All right, what we got next? All right, next we have the goggles 3. It's the goggles 3. It's like some cushion they put in there. They feel smaller. I don't know. But now, when it did, that's nice and cushioned right there. So instead of putting the pressure the way it used to fit, it would go from here to here right near your temples and would kind of squeeze your head to keep it on. Now the pressure is applied to your forehead, so this attaches to the forehead and then this just goes over your eyes. And they have this nice cushion right here, so there's no pressure on the eyes. They went back to the adjustments for the eyes, so you don't wear glasses when you're wearing these. You can adjust your distance and your prescription using these knobs. So if you have perfect vision, you can just, but I wear glasses. And that was one of the things I was always worried about. The Integra headset had inserts that you would put in for whatever your prescription was. I like this because this is going to allow me to adjust it to my eyes. I actually have astigma, so my eyes are a little tricky. One of the other things that these added, it has a defog. So inside the app, there's a defog so that they would fog up on me. With this now, you can turn on a fan and it defogs the glass so it doesn't fog up. When I heard about that, I was like, oh, okay, yeah. And there were a couple of other technical things. In the front, they have these cameras, and these cameras will actually allow you to do like a pass-through. So instead of taking off the goggles to see where I'm at, if anybody's around me or I'm getting ready to land, I can double tap on the side, and that will allow me to use these cameras to see where I'm at. So I'm interested in seeing what those look like and what's the resolution there. And the other thing I was wondering about was the internal recording. So there is a slot for a micro SD inside the headset. So that's the goggles right there. Okay, What else we got in here? All right. This is the battery charging hub. So the batteries go in here, they just slide right in. And USB-C. I forget, I think if you press the power button for 3 seconds or something like that, and what will happen is it will look at all three batteries, and whatever battery is the lowest, it'll use the, it basically it combines the batteries to charge one of the batteries. So if I have three that are kind of like halfway down, I can press that and it's going to take all the juice from the other two, throw it into the one, and help that one charge. But that's the case right here. It's nice to know that everything fits inside this bag, so I can put all this back in this bag, and when I'm when I want to go fly, I'm ready to fly. I just grab this bag and go. And since it's USB-C, you can use this as in to charge the batteries, or out so you using the batteries to charge something else like a cell phone or whatever, camera, whatever else you got. All right. And this is the drone right here. So let's make sure there's nothing else in the bag. No. These pockets, they do have some Velcro on them, but they're not, doesn't feel like they're going to move around. So it's set up a certain way. And you got like a little flap there. But other than that, nope. You got that handle. This handle on the front, pocket on the side. You got pockets on both sides. The expandable pockets on both sides. And your zipper pocket in the front here. So you can put something on the side, probably filters or something. But that's the bag. All right. So now we're going to move on to this right here is the lanyard. It's the lanyard for the controller. Somebody call it the Wii, whatever. All right. This is the Avata 2, the FPV drone. Feels lighter. It's got the battery already inserted. So there's three batteries. This has already got one battery already in it. Definitely feels lighter. They switched around the motors. And this drone is small enough that you can fly it indoors doing real estate work, inspections, things like that. Or you can take it out. Can do flips. That's one of the other things I was interested in using it for, because I like doing the little aerial shots and different things. I like using I'll do more cinematic, like slow moving panning shots, establishing shots with that. This I'm going to use for more fun and maybe a couple action shots or different things, flying through the forest. I don't know. But this, it's very versatile. I'll take this, fly it over water, fly it near trees. It's got these guards built in on the side. So I don't have to worry about it. I have the Care Protect on it, so if I crash it or anything, I just send it off and I give them a couple dollars and they send me back a new one. In fact, I just did that with my first Avata. I had broken the propeller and it had some grass damage and different things, and I sent it back to them and they sent it back to me. And it's still new in the box. It's a completely new drone. They don't fix it and then send it back. And then you have to, like, this isn't right, that isn't right. They just send you a new one. So that's why I like the Care Refresh. All right, so what else we got on here? One of the major improvements, they move the SD card. So now it is on the side and it's got a flip-up door. So the SD card is right there on the side, along with your USB-C connection so you can charge it and offload your footage right there, nice and easy. and that door goes, it closes real nice. That is almost so easy. Okay. Check to activate the intelligent flight battery before using the first time. Okay. Roger that. Do not touch the air intake, avoid burns. Okay. Roger that. And let's see what this one says. It says 181 BL. Oh. Decibels. 81 decibels. And that was actually covering over the screen. I wonder if that's the sound rating. I mean, decibels is sound, so. It's also got these two motion sensors in the back. They are not obstacle avoidance. They are motion sensors. Because one of the things, if it had motion avoidance, we wouldn't be able to fly it in tight spaces. And let's see. Pinch the cap and it slides right off. It's just a little pinch. Make sure you take off. If you ever get anything that has a camera, always make sure you get this piece of plastic off of them. Home security, anything like that. The camera is improved. It's got a better sensor, a little bit bigger. This gimbal guard is kind of nice. Kind of slides on there. Yeah. Okay. Weighted battery. One of the other problems I had with the other one, it was open in the back and the batteries were, it seemed like every time I crashed, the battery would slide out. This has got the two locking on the side here. So you have to push those in to slide it out. And then when you push it in, it locks in. So that's nice and secure. Because I was flying one place and it crashed, the battery went flying, and then I spent about a half an hour trying to find the drone. And that's kind of scary. So that's good to know. That's nice in there and secure. But yeah, feels lighter. Definitely a lot of improvements. They take a lot of feedback and they try to implement it into the next version. I don't want to say that I'm a DJI fanboy, but I do appreciate good work and the constant improvement that they do, which doesn't really make it a hesitation for me to buy their products because I know that it's quality and it's not that they're just going to slap a new number on it. They've actually improved it. So if you have any questions, please hit me up in the comments. I'm going to be going through the manual, getting it set up, charging it up, and hopefully I'll be able to fly this pretty soon. The weather right now is a little shaky, and I'm waiting for that really nice day so I can go out there and do a little ripping with this.